The Tragic Spread of Crack, Saturday at 7:30. This is Eyewitness News with Bill Beutel, John Johnson for Kaity Tong, plus Eli Zaret, Dr. Bill Gutch for Storm Field, and the Eyewitness News team.
Good evening, I'm Bill Beutel. Tonight there are many unanswered questions surrounding the death of a 2.5-year-old boy in Queens. He died during a visit to a dentist, and there have been investigations begun. Garrett Glazer details this mystery for us right now.
At the office of Forest Hills dentist Philip Howard this morning, they weren't taking questions.
Can you give us his lawyer's name? Cops are here. Can we talk to his lawyer? Not even his lawyer's name? You want us to leave?
Yes.
Meanwhile, friends and family came to pay respects at the Forest Hills Gardens home of 2.5-year-old Rifa Setiono today. He died following efforts to revive him after breathing troubles at Dr. Howard's office yesterday. The family is prominent in New York's Indonesian community. Relatives and friends referred our questions to the family's New York attorney, but efforts to reach him were unsuccessful.
Police have a lot of questions. Why would a 2.5-year-old boy be having his teeth filled? Why would the dentist use Valium and pentothal as an anesthetic? And why would the dentist reportedly have slammed the door in the face of arriving paramedics and refused to let them in?
At the 112th precinct today, police were not saying much. State investigators and homicide detectives from the Queens DA's office say they're looking at the case as well.
It will be the responsibility of my office to determine whether the activities by Dr. Howard were proper and competent and done according to the scope of authorized dentistry.
Results of an autopsy have not yet been released. Investigators want to know whether there's been any criminal wrongdoing, and they expect to have some answers within 10 days, which doesn't help the grief much tonight for one Queens family whose 2.5-year-old is gone. In Forest Hills, Garrett Glazer, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
The young fashion model slashed in the face early yesterday has captured the heart of New York with her courage. She met with reporters today to tell her story. And even as that was happening, Mike Parker tells us the three suspects were being arraigned in connection with the attack.
Marla Hanson, who had modeled for Glamour and Mademoiselle magazines, then was slashed in what police say was an attack for hire, faced reporters in the hospital today. The former cheerleader from Independence, Missouri, said she still fears the men who ripped her face to shreds.
I think that somebody that does something like this, just out of cold blood, shouldn't be walking around because he'll do it again to somebody else or maybe to me.
Her plastic surgeon told reporters those scars will take 9 to 12 months to heal and will probably be permanent.
I have never shivered looking at wounds the way I did with her. When I finished suturing her up at 6:30 in the morning, I sat down and I thought to myself, how could men push a woman like this down and carve her face up with a razor?
The three men allegedly involved in the attack were arraigned today. Her landlord and makeup artist, Stephen Roth, the man who allegedly orchestrated the attack, was held on bail of $250,000. The two men charged with the razor attack itself were ordered held on $100,000 bail each. Outside the courtroom, Stephen Roth's lawyer had little to say.
The nature of the crime obviously is a very serious crime, and it's a hideous crime. Beyond that, I can't say anything.
People say a lot of bad things about New York, and of course my parents and, excuse me, a lot of people expected something like this to happen when I moved here, but the people here have been so nice and so supportive, and I've gotten more attention than I deserved, really.
Obviously, wanting to continue her modeling career and actually being able to do it are two different things. Marla understands that, and she says that if she cannot continue to model, there are any number of things she can do with her life. Painting and acting, she said, are just two. Obviously, this girl does not know how to give up. At St. Vincent's Hospital, Mike Parker, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Tonight, Marla's father, Robert Hanson, is flying from Texas to be with his daughter. His plane is delayed because of the weather. Louis Young is at Kennedy Airport and will have a report when he arrives. Bill.
A police officer was hurt and a police robot was badly damaged when a pipe bomb exploded this morning in Mineola. The second bombing this week at the Interboro Mutual Indemnity Insurance Company. An employee showed up for work, spotted a broken window, and looked inside and saw what turned out to be a pipe bomb with batteries and a timer attached to it. Police evacuated the area and rerouted the traffic on Mineola Boulevard while a robot tried to dismantle the bomb.
It's a mechanical device that operates remotely through the use of a television camera. It has an arm and a claw that can pick up various devices and carry it to our explosive truck. It was in the process of getting in to get this device when it blew up.
Nassau police officer Robert Wiggins was hit with flying glass. He was not hurt badly. The mystery, though, tonight is the motive behind it. Police have no idea who did it or why they would have done it. There was an explosion in Lower Manhattan this morning. The two manhole covers blew up on Rector Street near the World Trade Center. Four passersby injured, none of them seriously. They were treated at the scene. Police say it could have been a great deal worse. The explosion was caused by a backup of gas.
A suspect is charged tonight with killing a young girl whose burned body was found in a Brooklyn subway station last February. Police say they acted on a call to Crime Stoppers. The number was 577-TIPS. They say they caught the suspect because he gave the victim's jewelry to his girlfriend. And as Art McFarlane tells us, he was already at Rikers Island charged with raping six women.
It was in mid-March that police arrested 22-year-old Derek Hamilton and charged him with a series of rapes, including one at Brooklyn College. It was a particularly brutal rape, the victim stabbed and beaten. Since that time, Hamilton has been held at Rikers Island. Well, today, here at the 71st Precinct in Brooklyn, department officials announced that Hamilton has now been charged with murder in the death of an 18-year-old woman whose burned body was found back in February in the tower room at a Brooklyn subway station. The murder victim's body was later identified as 18-year-old Monica Critchlow. Officials today explained how they were led to believe Hamilton was her murderer.
It says, at that time, we discovered that certain jewelry had been recovered from the arrests for rape, which resembled some of the jewelry having been worn by Monica Critchlow.
Hamilton was subsequently placed in a lineup and was identified as having been with Monica Critchlow the day she was killed.
We were able to determine that Mr. Hamilton visited a female friend the night Monica's body was discovered and presented her that jewelry as a gift.
He gave a dead woman's jewelry to someone that he was pursuing romantically?
Yes.
Police say they will continue to investigate the series of rapes they believe Hamilton committed. Meanwhile, he will be arraigned for the murder of Monica Critchlow on Monday. In Brooklyn, Art McFarlane, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
And police have captured Aaron Bonds, the man who made a daring escape from Rikers Island yesterday. Bonds was found in the home of a relative in Brooklyn, hiding under a bed.
Coming up, Macy's might not tell you, but we will, that by the end of the year, a major force in the retail business is going to close its doors.
And by year's end, the Wolfman Skating Rink may be back in business. That story just ahead.
Eyewitness News is brought to you in part by Tri-State Ford.
Captain Black, America's number one pipe tobacco, for many reasons.
Wagon, how do you get around carting all that stuff?
I'm a Ford Taurus, like you. Front-wheel drive.
Oh, yeah? Try hooking a left at 53rd and 5th against three lanes of traffic.
You can't turn left there.
I didn't think you could handle this city. See, you're better off out here with a...
Motor Trend's Car of the Year, the Ford Taurus, wagon or sedan. One's right for who you are and what you do. See one at your local Ford dealer.
Try driving a wagon full of wet kids back from Asbury Park, wise guy.
Mr. Secretary, are you saying no further cuts can be made?
That is correct, Senator.
I see here enormous expenditures on MeisterCraft.
Our boys deserve an expensive beer, sir.
My committee informs me it's not expensive. Just tastes expensive.
Actually, that's under my assistant, Mr. Macklin.
Well, what's he doing with the money he's supposed to spend on beer?
Oh, Mac, it's a darling little boat.
Rich, smooth MeisterBrow. It only tastes expensive.
Put down that book and come to bed. The Blue Bicycle. Pick it up at bookstores everywhere. Honey? But be prepared not to put it down.
New York City is going to lose another piece of the past. Gimbel's, for so very long a part of Herald Square, the place you'd go for a bargain when you couldn't find it at Macy's, is closing. The violinist was playing at Gimbel's this noon. Not a funeral dirge, but a kind of serenade for those few who came for the bargains that made Gimbel's famous. The British company that owns Gimbel's is selling the store at Herald Square and the one at 86th and Lexington.
Well, we're losing an institution. It's been here since I was a little boy. It seems funny if it's not going to be here anymore.
Gimbel's is like part of New York.
How long have you been shopping at Gimbel's?
All my life, and I'm not a youngster.
Gimbel's is an old tradition in New York City. Who among us can remember when this store was not here? But in New York City, traditions last only so long as they're productive. And Gimbel's is no longer productive. So the tradition will die. Not for us to judge if Gimbel's management was bad. In fact, they tried to buy the stores themselves, but couldn't do it. Still, to walk through Gimbel's at Herald Square is to understand that business is not so good. The company that owns and will sell Gimbel's has stopped ordering any new merchandise, clearing the floors for the sale of the place at the end of the year, clearing the way for the developers who build something else here, marching to the special music of progress. In the almost final goodbye, thank you for shopping at Gimbel's. Beutel Incorporated owns the 28 Gimbel stores. All will be sold to another British company. In New York City, at Herald Square, and at Lexington at 86th, 5,000 people who work for Gimbel's will lose their jobs. John?
Well, Bill, the doors of Gimbel's may be closing, but you can sharpen your ice skates and head for Central Park. Donald Trump is doing what the city says it can't do, get Waltman Rink ready for this winter. The story from Will Spence.
It doesn't look like it now, but you'll be able to skate at Central Park's Woman Rink this November. Donald Trump is going to make magic here this fall. A precedent-setting agreement between Mr. Trump and the city of New York for Mr. Trump to build Woman Rink, and the city will reimburse him. After days of negotiation, the announcement this afternoon at City Hall, and of course, Mayor Koch spoke first.
Thanks to an offer by Donald Trump, Woman Rink will be ready for skating this winter after all. Donald has a reputation for completing projects on time and keeps a tight rein on expenses.
In the next couple of days, Trump and city officials will sit down and decide just how much it's going to cost to rebuild Woolman Rink. Once that figure is set, it will be the cap. And when the construction is finished, Mr. Trump will pay any cost overruns, and he will be reimbursed by the city for the cost, not his expenses, but the cost of construction when the rink is operational.
The man said that he's not going to charge the city. And for that, every New Yorker should be grateful. I'm especially grateful because I'm a skater, and 3 years ago, I remember vividly my family's holiday card.
He's not going to charge the city for his services, the cost of the thing we are paying.
What are you, you're a pig to boot? man just gave you a free gift, and you won what? You won his suit?
And then with cameras watching, Trump finally spoke.
The truth is that I want to get it done, and I want to get it done for the city. One of the reasons that I'm actually putting up my money, hopefully the city will reimburse me, but if they don't, I guess I made just another bad deal. But I'm putting forward the $2.5 million or the $3 million or whatever it's going to cost to get this built. And as soon as it's built and completed, I assume the city will reimburse me. If they don't, what can I tell you? It's been the story of my life with the city.
It'll be a better deal than the generals.
Okay, you're right.
As you can clearly see, Donald Trump takes his promise to rebuild Woman Rink very seriously. Just minutes after the news conference, he is here in Central Park inspecting Woman Rink. The name of the rink will not change, but when he does it, it will be forever known as the rink that Donald Trump built. Will Spence, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Theodore Tia is a new name to most of us. Today, he resigned his job on the City Planning Commission. And that's interesting, because Theodore Tia is secretary of the Bronx Democratic Party, a man close to Stanley Friedman, who is chairman of the Bronx Party and who has been indicted in connection with a city scandal that will not go away. Tia was also Bronx Borough President Stanley Simon's campaign manager, and he is now chairman of the Bronx Broadcasting Company, which has so far failed to bring cable TV to the Bronx. Bronx DA Mario Merola says he is, in fact, the object of several investigations. As it happened, Mayor Koch appointed him to his second term on the City Planning Commission in 1985. Till today, when he resigned, he was not at all well known. But if past his prologue, he might well become more well known in the days shortly ahead. Victor Botnick, the head of the city's Health and Hospitals Corporation, has been ordered by Mayor Koch to perform 30 days of community service. The mayor says the punishment is for Botnick's misleading statements about his college education or absence of it. You'll recall that it was after our questioning yesterday that Botnick disclosed he lied to the city and to the press about his college degree. And as Tappy Phillips reports now, there are still some shadows on the decisions Botnick made in the past.
The news conference was called to set the record straight. Victor Botnick admitted that he had told reporters that he had a college degree when in fact he didn't. But Botnick was unable to be completely honest when I asked him if he had written the same lie on a 1978 city background questionnaire.
Question directly. Did you on the first background questionnaire say that you had graduated from college?
I responded an appropriate way on the first background questionnaire, and that's all I have to say.
The truth is that Botnick did say he had received a Bachelor of Science degree from Mercy College on that questionnaire and was called before the Department of Investigation to explain that falsehood. The matter was closed when Botnick explained, "I did so with the thought that I had obtained the 120 credits toward a degree." Victor Botnick met Mayor Koch when they were both traveling in Israel in the early 1970s. He first went to work for him as a volunteer on his congressional campaign. And over the years, he grew to become a trusted friend and advisor. In fact, the mayor has depended on Botnick to sort out the truth from lies during many of the city's biggest changes and crises. He was on the job screening committee in 1978 when the first Koch administration was formed. He was part of the investigation into the death of Eleanor Bumpers at the hands of a New York City policeman. He headed the investigation into possible misconduct by medical examiner Elliot Gross. He determined city strategy when New York's water supply was threatened by plutonium contamination, and he personally investigated the EMS response time in the death of a 10-year-old Coney Island girl. Mayor Koch clearly values Botnick's advice and judgment highly, but he is also the first to admit, as he did in a news conference on Tuesday, that Botnick doesn't always use good sense.
Now, if I had 300,000 Victor Botnicks, I'd worry about it.
Tappy Phillips, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Up next, the legal news tightens around the landlord some tenants call Dracula.
And we invite you to meet the refrigerator's rival on the football field and in music videos. He's called The World. We'll have his story in a moment.
What is...
When a meal lacks flavor, there's a lot of things you can try.
Just say when, sir.
You can add spices to your salad. You can sprinkle salt on your steak. You can pour ketchup on your meatloaf all day long. But nothing can bring excitement to a meal like Accent. Because Accent wakes up the natural flavors in food that are already there. So don't say when, say Accent. Accent wakes up the flavor in your favorite foods.
Last year, in a head-to-head comparison between the Honda Accord and the Mercedes-Benz 190E, the editors of Road and Track found the two almost identical in acceleration, braking, ride, and a dozen other performance characteristics. This year's performance comparisons aren't in yet, but the price comparisons are. And if you don't mind doing without their hood ornament, the 1986 Honda Accord can save you over $10,000. Get the car at the dealer, your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut tri-Honda dealer.
Ice cream, everywhere. It's ShopRite's greatest ice cream sale ever all week long. Save up to 40% on many of your favorite brands. Save on ice cream on sticks, in sandwiches and cups. Save on sherbets and pops. Save on ice cream for sundaes, ice cream for sodas. Save at ShopRite on half gallons of Flavor King ice cream for just 99 cents. Yes, it's ShopRite's greatest ice cream sale ever, and there's ice cream everywhere.
The next time business takes you to New York, check into the Essex House on Central Park South and feel the difference. Here, your body will be treated to elegance and comfort, but you'll also find special touches that speak to the soul. A warm, intimate, caring atmosphere. A hotel that brings out the best in you. Call 800-NICO-US for reservations at New York's Essex House. NICO Hotels International, for the body and the soul.
It was landlords versus tenants again today. The landlords, the Spodek brothers. For the tenants, tales of frustration. John Mahler offers three examples, all told today in Brooklyn Housing Court. John.
John, first some perspective. Between the two Spodek brothers, they reportedly own and or operate as many as 60 New York apartment buildings. They have been in court many times with many more appearances to come. Today's three cases certainly give you a feel for the legal entanglements.
We begin with the Spodek building on Newkirk Avenue. A number of tenants have been on a rent strike. They say needed repairs have not been made.
There's confusion as to which one of the Spodek brothers, Irving or Leonard, is responsible for the building, or if both are. The result, the case put off until another day in order to get some answers. Confused? Take the next case. Wilson Garcon, he has court documents showing an agreement by his landlord on East 18th Street to make repairs. His pictures, he says, show repairs have not been made. When the same landlord attorney from the first case couldn't tell the judge if the repairs had been made, the judge sent her to the telephone to get someone in court who could answer the question, had the repairs been made. The next problem, it was determined this case could not proceed because the tenant would need a court-approved French Creole speaking interpreter. And the landlord superintendent who was being summoned would need a Spanish speaking interpreter. But again in this case, the question, who is the landlord? Are you representing Irving nor Leonard Spodek?
I already commented, thank you.
Court records show attorney Kathy Schneider is representing Park Property Development in this case, listed on an attorney general's document as a Spodek company. Case 3, tenants against Spodek companies, Monarch Properties, and Interborough Management. In court, Irving Spodek attorney Howard Adler said he was confused about the proceeding because he and tenants attorney Gloria Bletter had agreed in writing to keep Irving as an individual out of the case until a lawsuit Irving has filed against his brother is resolved. Case put off.
We're totally frustrated. We're just being litigated to death. That's the name of the game. If you have the money to pay for the big attorneys, you make out in court. Otherwise, you just get killed.
So the Spodeks fight each other in state Supreme Court about who is responsible. The tenants are caught in the middle. They just want their buildings repaired. It's going to take some time. They'll have to be patient. It will take time to sort all of this out. Bill?
John, thank you very much. The Guardian Angels took their campaign against crack to the front door of one of the city's high schools today. Julia Richmond High School is on the east side of Manhattan, just down the street from a park at 67th Street and 1st Avenue, where the police say drug deals are made night and day. The Guardian Angels were there to pass out petitions, asking the Board of Education to hold classes on the dangers of crack before school lets out this month. Classes on the addictive and dangerous form of cocaine are not scheduled, in fact, to be held until fall. Harlem school children have their own campaign against crack underway. Today they chanted slogans about the drug's danger as they march from their schools to a District 5 field day in Mount Morris Park.
Should New York City cops be tested to see if they use cocaine and other drugs? That's just one of the tough questions explored by a legislative committee. Bob Blanchard joins us now to tell us where the committee came up with those answers and whether or not they waffled on some of the questions. Bob.
John, New York City police, on balance, are doing a good job, but if management makes some changes, the force can do better. That's the general conclusion of an investigation which studied the New York City Police Department for about a year. But one recommendation likely to draw fire is a suggestion that all New York City police be tested for drugs.
The report was released at a morning news conference and questions the quality of the New York City police force. The report says the city does not adequately screen police applicants to make sure the applicants are not mentally ill or unstable. Psychological tests are inadequate and should be overhauled, the report says. It goes on to say that all cops should be screened by a psychiatrist throughout their entire career to make sure they remain mentally competent. The report also recommends that the police department begin random testing for drugs of all cops. The report believes drug abuse among police officers is a bigger problem than corruption.
I do not think that any of the conclusions which we have drawn in this report should give rise to a fundamental concern that the police department is not capable of functioning at this time. What they can give rise to properly, in my judgment, is that over a period of time, if left unattended, the failure to cope with these management problems could bring about a decline in the quality of that force, and the ultimate implication of that could be a decrease in public safety.
The report also says that all too often police officers are promoted based on test results and not heroic crime-fighting work. The report believes if a cop does a good job in the field, that alone may be worth a promotion. Investigators also found that New York City police get into a lot of automobile accidents, some 3,000 last year alone, totaling 300 police cars. Late this afternoon, the police responded to the report, agreeing that drug testing is an effective tool and that psychological testing should be thorough.
I don't know of any police department in the country which fails based on a psychological test. As many candidates or as a larger proportion of candidates as the New York City Police Department does. In spite of that fact, we're still looking for new ways to screen, and we're experimenting with some new tests now.
Many of the suggestions in the report cannot be implemented unless the police unions go along, while some other suggestions like the drug testing will probably be decided in court. Another report is due out in about a month. Bill.
Thank you very much, Bob. Earlier in tonight's program, we heard from and you met the fashion model Marla Hanson, whose face, as you know, was slashed, tragically slashed with a razor night before last. Her father has just arrived at Kennedy Airport from Texas, and we're going right now to Lewis Young, who's at Kennedy, and he has a report. Lewis?
Well, Bill, Marla Hanson's father, Robert, is here right now. He just arrived moments ago. Press conference is in progress. Let's take a listen, at least, to what he has to say about what has happened to his daughter.
A new roommate. Gina was her first name, yes.
And then how long was it before you could talk to your daughter?
She was in surgery at the time the roommate called me. I was not able to speak with her until about 2:30 in the afternoon.
Now, she has been in remarkably good spirits, as we mentioned before. This is characteristic with her childhood, the way she has always lived her life?
I would think so, yes.
Your reaction again, sir, to this terrible thing that's happened to your daughter?
Well, at the present time, my only concern is for her, and that, of course, the reason I'm here is not for myself, but I hope that somehow I can bolster her spirits and maybe encourage her by being here.
Would you want to take her back to Texas?
I would love to. I doubt that she would, though.
She loves New York, huh?
Yes.
Are there other family members that are waiting to hear from you now?
Well, that is the
Probably.
Press conference
All the
in progress right now.
Would be anxious to hear
Robert
from
Hanson
you.
Just arrived from San Antonio, Texas.
Marla has here seven to, brothers and sisters.
He's here to bolster his daughter's spirits. He said that he's not surprised that she is in good spirits after the attack. She was a cheerleader class president, and he's here to see what he can do to help.
Grew up, we
reporting
took
live
other
from JFK,
children into the home.
Lewis Young, Channel 7 Eyewitness News. Back to you.
Thank you, Lewis. And I would expect that if that story develops, we'll go back to it through the course of this program. In a moment, Dr. Bill Gutsch will be along to take a look at the weather for the weekend.
And later, we're going to have a preview of a new music video star, Bring On the World, all 445 pounds of him.
When you want to get away from rock music, when you want to get away from elevator music, come to Light Music at 106.7 WLTW Light FM.
Lately, something's been happening to Japanese car prices. Japanese cars are often loaded with options that don't leave you with much of an option. Their prices simply aren't as low as you think. On the other hand, the price of the German-engineered Volkswagen Jetta isn't as high as you might think. You can buy a Jetta for $88.80, and the options really are optional. Sayonara.
This Tiffany bowl was made for the Belmont Stakes champion. It's priceless, and so is the honor of winning it.
Affirmed and allied are heads apart. Affirmed's got a nose in front as he come onto the wire.
Their names read like royalty.
It's Seattle Sleuth. In the stretch, here he comes, and he's opening it up again.
This Saturday, the Belmont Stakes. It's more than a great race. It's a great tradition.
I got a cut C, but mine belongs to Medigroup. So I could go to the doctor whenever I need to. Like when I fell right here. Mom said Medigroup is an HMO from Blue Cross and Blue Shield in New Jersey. And with Medigroup, Mom says everything is covered, even x-rays on my knee. Mom got Medigroup at her job for the whole family, but I think it's mostly for me. Medigroup, the HMO from the name you know.
Why don't you come up to my place and we'll have a few laughs?
This is the place to be for a good time.
She's gonna talk dirty to the government.
This gang works hard for their money.
Hey, why are you busting my chops?
Because you're ignoring mine.
And they work hard for their honeys.
This is terrific. It's just like having dynasty right here at work.
So let them entertain you.
I got a reputation, you know?
We know.
It's laughing. It's loving.
Oh, yeah.
It's a living. Come on and join the fun. Saturday at 7 on Channel 7.
There's something touching and moving about a whale made helpless. So it is, there's a frantic effort in Florida right now to save a group of helpless whales. They're among 28 whales that beached themselves on an island off Fort Myers yesterday. Rescuers freed and are caring for 14 sick whales, and 12 whales died before they could be rescued at all. Two swam back to sea on their own. They were able to get back. And officials say they don't know why the whales beached themselves, but as I say, they are trying very hard to save them. And that's always a hard thing to do once a whale has been beached.
John? With us now is Dr. Bill Gutsch, has been doing some celestial calculations about Ramadan, which is the most holy part of the year for the Muslim world, right? Why have you been doing that?
Well, we get a lot of inquiries at the planetarium about this because officially Ramadan begins when the moon is first sighted after the new moon. Mm-hmm. And that was last month, and so now it's coming to an end. And the new moon will be Saturday morning, and we think that the first time it will be sighted will be Sunday night.
So Ramadan ends Sunday.
Sunday, according to our best estimates at this point. Okay, let's take a look at current temperatures. Quite a range around the area, and we have the first tropical storm of the season on the map as well. We are looking at temperatures from the 90s, or around 90, to the 60s. A couple of reasons. Up in here, it is to the north of a front that straddles the region. Here we are to the south of the front, southerly winds across land. Long Island getting southerly winds, but that's across the ocean, and so they are cool with the sea breeze. It is going to stay muggy, though, which everybody has right on through the weekend. We were only 3 degrees above normal today. If it weren't for the outrageously high relative humidity, it would have been a gorgeous day, or at least a very comfortable day, but oh, what a difference the humidity makes. Satellite image, clouds over us, and that'll be the story for the next couple of days, as we'll talk about in a minute. But first, let's center our attention on Tropical Storm Andrew, the first of the season. Current location of the center of the storm, about 200 miles south of Wilmington, North Carolina. It has been stationary for the last several hours. It is expected to resume a slow trek to the north over the next 12 to 24 hours. We will watch it. Max sustained winds 40 miles per hour, higher gusts, as is typically the case, to the east of the storm. This band of clouds is a frontal system, separates very hot and humid air to the south from cooler and drier air well to the north, but the front is going to be just about on us all weekend with rather humid conditions prevailing. Front over us, scattered showers, thundershowers, and thunderstorms rippling northeastward along the front, and so it's going to be hit and miss stuff right through the weekend. Northern fringes of the rain area from Tropical Storm Andrew, you don't see the rest of the rain because the radar does not see that far off the coast. There's the battle zone on the map. The front will sit on us for the next day and a half. Cloudy skies through tomorrow night, intermittent chance of a shower or a thundershower. Sunday, it looks like the front may push to the north. It may bring out the sun that'll just shoot the temperatures up and make it awfully uncomfortable everywhere except at the beach. It's back to summer, and here's the forecast. For tonight, we will call for cloudy conditions. It'll be warm and humid. A shower or a thundershower is possible at just about any time, just about anywhere. Low temperatures in the 60s. Tomorrow, same forecast. High temperatures like today in the 70s. Tomorrow night, same forecast. Low temperatures again in the 60s. Sunday, we'll say variably cloudy skies, hinting at the possibility of some sun. If we get it, it's just going to make it more uncomfortable with temperatures getting higher. About the only relief will be with a sea breeze right along the shore. Head for it if you can, if you don't mind putting up with the traffic, and that's it.
Okay, thanks very much, Bill. In a moment, religious leaders plan their roles in the Liberty Weekend festivities.
And a football player, that's not him, there it is, Call the World, takes on music videos and wins. What is this?
You're cool, you're crisp, you're hard to resist, you're right.
Ooh, refreshing light.
A couple of years ago, I found myself in a situation where I had to cheer up a clown. The circus was passing through Pittsburgh, and he'd broken his glasses. He bought his glasses at Pearl, but in Denver. So he was happy to hear that with the Pearl guarantee, he could get glasses replaced free at any Pearl, in any city.
Pearl people know eyes, and they care.
It was nice knowing I could make a clown smile.
Nobody cares for eyes more than Pearl.
It was one of those days. I was glad I brought my Captain Black. It smokes cool on any occasion. The aroma pleases the most finicky host. And the flavor lasts and lasts and lasts. Yes, I've introduced Captain Black to many friends. Captain Black, America's number one pipe tobacco, for many reasons.
The factory authorized clearance sale. The factories authorize your Dodge boys to offer 8.8 financing or $500 cash back on Dodge Lancer, so they're having a clearance sale. Lancer offers an optional turbo engine, room for five, front-wheel drive handling, electronic fuel injection, hatchback five-door convenience, and 550 protection. And now with 8.8, your monthly payment can be as low as $185 per month. The factory authorized clearance sale. Going on now at the Dodge boys with 8.8 or $500 cash back on Dodge Lancer.
The bells will be ringing on Liberty Weekend. Church bells across the country will ring out in unison to mark the 100th anniversary of the Statue of Liberty. Doug Johnson was at St. Patrick's Cathedral today when the plan was unveiled.
A small bell being rung by Cardinal O'Connor on the steps of St. Patrick's Cathedral this noon hour. The idea to announce the ceremony of the bells. Joining Cardinal O'Connor, opera stars Robert Merrill and Anna Moffo and leaders of other religions who will take part in a special mass on July 3rd. But the ceremony of the bells will be a plan to have freedom ring all across this country.
We don't want to forget what's most fundamental, and that's the most fundamental freedom of all, and that's the freedom to worship. So at noon on July the 3rd, we're going to ask all the churches and town halls all over the country to let freedom ring across America for 100 seconds to commemorate what else? 100 years of the Statue of Liberty and all that she stands for.
Since so many hundreds of thousands of those who came through Ellis Island came here seeking religious liberty, and it would be, of course, unfortunate, therefore, if there were no recognition or celebration of that fact.
It had been reported the Pope would take part in a special mass by satellite. Cardinal O'Connor said that is not the plan. All religions have been invited to take part in the bell-ringing ceremony. However, the Cardinal said it's been pointed out to him that synagogues don't have bells to ring. However, he said that several rabbis have told him that synagogues will be asked, and this is serious, to ring their burglar alarms. At St. Patrick's Cathedral, Doug Johnson, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
We change the subject drastically and we go to football and music videos. Rather an unlikely combination, you might say, but a 445-pound high school football star from Florida is now starring in a music video. It has already won an award for it, awards that were handed out today at the Limelight. Never one to duck the limelight, Carol Iavana was there.
You're looking at the frizz.
You've heard of football's William the Refrigerator Perry. Well, look out, because now there is Raymond the World Smith. He's a 445-pound high school student from Washington, D.C., who plays football and appears in a music video, too. But this video won first prize in the Nutrition Music Video Contest, sponsored by the Florida Department of Citrus. All the nutrition videos in the contest had one goal: to drive home the value of good nutrition. Students from 25 high schools across the country entered the contest. They had to come up with their own video concept, write the lyrics, play the music, record it, and film entirely on their own. The video entered by the students from Woodson High School in Washington, D.C. won because officials thought the rap style used in it really drove the point home. Although Raymond the World Smith is happy he won, he didn't want to do it at first.
I didn't want to do it. Miss Foster forced me to do it. So I had no other choice but to do it. If I wouldn't have did it, she'd have kept worrying me.
Who forced you to do this?
Miss Foster.
Could you get up here, please? You mean to tell me you let her force you to do this?
Yes.
The six other students who worked on the project each had their job to do. Richard Growlick was the man behind the camera. Brad Solding wrote the lyrics and played the music. Robert Spears was on sound. Stephanie McNeil also wrote the lyrics and, of course, performed in it, as did Kim Melbourne. The winners were given a check for $1,500, but more than the money, they had the joy of seeing themselves in their own music video. And that's a grade these students can really be proud of. At the Limelight, I'm Carol Iavana, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Kodak out of focus, and the rest of the day in business.
And later on, the thundering hoofbeats of a few great horses at Belmont as riders on their mounts get ready for the third jewel in the Triple Crown, the Belmont Stakes.
It was only a matter of time. Acura Integra, a new dimension in sports sedans from a new division of American Honda. Precision craftsmanship and 16-valve dual overhead cam performance bring new sophistication to fun. Acura Integra, exclusively at Acura dealers.
What do you expect for 300 calories? All that for 300 calories? Beef, good news for people who eat.
High technology, that's the key to the extra productivity of Canon Business Systems. And as a subsidiary of Canon USA, we are the source for Canon business products.
Canon laser copiers, Canon plain paper laser facsimiles, personal copiers, electronic typewriters, word processors, and micrographic systems. Call us toll-free 1-800-438-8600 for your nearby MCS regional center.
I don't always have time for my morning paper, but I exercise a marvelous alternative. When I can't read all about it, I hear all about it.
WCBS News Radio 88.
My work in show business doesn't give me time to organize my own life, but I can still find out what's going on. When I can't read all about it, I hear all about it.
WCBS News Radio 88.
Kodak says things aren't exactly clicking for it, so it won't be able to offer a trade-in for its instant cameras. More than 3 million people own Kodak instant cameras, but Kodak was forced out of that end of the business several months ago when Polaroid sued and won. But Kodak says many of its customers are suing, asking for cash compensation, and the matter is tied up in the courts. It won't be resolved for a long time, and if you have a Kodak instant camera, well, you get the picture.
Well, a little bit of a photo finish on Wall Street today. The stock market stayed in neutral for much of this business day, neither charging ahead nor falling back very much. But then a rally in the afternoon took hold, and the Dow Jones Industrials closed the week at a record high of 1885.90, up 6.46, on a volume of 110,910,000 shares traded on the New York Stock Exchange. One of the economy's key indicators, the jobless rate, was released today by the Commerce Department. U.S. unemployment for May was 7.3%, and that's a jump of 0.2% over April. The industry's hardest hit were manufacturing, which lost 40,000 jobs, and oil and gas, 30,000. Those sectors showing strength include construction, service, and financial industries. Locally, New York State unemployment climbed almost 0.5%, New Jersey almost a full point, and only New York City showed a drop in unemployment, a drop of 0.8%. The hard-hit oil patch gets more bad news as the price of oil slips a bit more. West Texas Intermediate crude selling at $12.90 a barrel today. Ted Turner announced today he's selling MGM to United Artists. The price, $300 million. In a separate sale, MGM's production facilities will go to Lorimar Telepictures for $190 million. Turner will keep MGM's library of motion pictures. And from Crane's New York business desk today, the weekly average of New York regional stocks closed at 280.84, down 2.83, and that compares with the National Standard & Poor's Index, which fell 1.68. Among regional companies, the big gainers include Phillips Van Heusen, up 5 1/8 on favorable earnings reports, and Translux, up 2 7/8 because of the sale of theaters to Paramount. Losers for the week include J. Walter Thompson, off 3.5, and Manhattan National, down 1.5. Manhattan National manufactures Perry Ellis designs, and Perry Ellis died last week, leaving some doubt about the future of his company. That's our report for this business day, and of course, also for this business week.
And coming up, Eli Zarrett with a sports lineup, including another big win for the Mets.
And a big win in Houston. The Rockets explode on the home court against the Celtics. The big win, the big brawl, the big news in a moment.
I'm Peter Jennings. Teenage unemployment remains a very serious problem in much of the country, but a curious thing is happening this year as the school year comes to a close and summer jobs become available. In some places, applications for jobs normally filled by teenagers are not being filled out. And some teenagers say they just don't want to work unless the money is good or their summer employment is useful for a later career. We'll have all that on World News tonight. We'll also have our regular Friday feature, The Person of the Week, right after Eyewitness News.
Food is
Nissan trucks that built tougher. New Nissan trucks that built smarter. New Nissan trucks that built bigger.
They're available now at your Tri-State Nissan dealer.
This Friday and Saturday, it's Siemens Bedroom Days, featuring Siemens' luxurious new collection of Italian lacquer bedrooms in black, white, and gray. Now at greatly reduced introductory prices. Get big savings on contemporary and traditional bedrooms, many reduced by over $500. Save up to 30% on your choice of colonial and contemporary oak-tone bedrooms. Save even more on bedroom furniture for teens, children, or that spare room. Many pieces only $77. Siemens Bedroom Days, Friday and Saturday only.
This summer, a very special lady is having a very special birthday. And New York State hopes you'll come celebrate and stay for a while.
Some folks like to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood. I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind.
So come, celebrate, stay for a while, and put yourself in a New York state of mind.
If you've ever been angry, you know that anger can get you really moving, and that's what happened last night in Houston. Eli's there.
Hard to say who was the angriest last night, but quite a game there in Houston. There will be a game six for the NBA Finals, though it is unlikely that anything will match the drama and shocking surprise of the melee that happened in Houston last night. Ralph Sampson and Jerry Seichting, lower left side of the screen, elbowing as they come down court. Then, this in the second quarter, Sampson delivers a punch and it gets crazy. Quickly thereafter, Dennis Johnson and Sampson get into it. The bench is clear, and Sampson and Seichting grapple on the floor. Celtics would later set the tone for a return to Boston. Wear your hard hats, Bird suggested. Prepare for more fighting, said Johnson. Sampson, the only player rejected wriggles free, begins to kick at Seichting and everything else. The loss of Sampson definitely inspired the Rockets, who went on an 11-0 run to win by 15. Wiggins, McRae, and Reed pass well with Peterson jamming on the drive. Akeem then was impossible to stop. 32 points, 14 rebounds, 8 blocks, stuffing that follow, then moving inside for an off-balance layup. But the emotional Rockets going to Boston down 3-2 are still in a very precarious position. As for the fisticuffs,
I thought it was a foul should have been called. Somebody jumped at me, and I did what I had to do to protect myself.
I guess I was in his way. He elbowed me once, and then somebody else took a shot, and he elbowed me again. That's when they called a foul. My little boys hit me harder than that.
It says that this team has a lot of heart, and that we've persevered through a lot of tough times. The first two games in Boston, the tough luck loss in game four, and this team has endured a lot of things, and we think it's a magical season that it's meant to be, and we think we're going to make history by winning two in Boston.
Maybe, but not likely. The Mets lead Montreal by 8.5 games, coupling more fine play with the Expos' 5-game losing streak. So the Mets are proceeding to make a mockery out of the outclassed National League East. They are playing superb defense this afternoon in Pittsburgh. Maybe this evening, we should say. First inning off Barry Bonds. Foster back to the warning track, makes a fine over-the-shoulder grab to retire the rookie. Then with a man on, league leading hitter Johnny Ray ground sharply to Santana, shuttles to Backman, who completes the double play to end the first. Mets threatened in the second. Strawberry singled, preceding Foster's drive off Roden. Watch the rookie Bonds make a great one-handed grab and relay to Ballyard, the cutoff man, who then fires a strike to Pena, and the straw man is dead at the plate. But they did score in the inning. Knight here singles up the middle. Foster comes around to put the Mets ahead 1-0. They are now in the bottom of the third. It is still 1-0. The Mets leading Pittsburgh. Last night, instrumental in the win was George Foster, who was again playing like the Foster who terrorized the league Back in the 70s, George crushes a Kipper pitch into the second deck and left. Two-run blast, his team leading 10th, and all in the last month. As the Mets pull ahead 2-0 in the second. In the fifth, they got five. Key blow, Kevin Mitchell's bloop. Two-run single, as all this while the Expos were getting beaten again in Philadelphia to fall further behind. And while Mitchell is caught stretching, Bob Ojeda was rolling to his first National League shutout. Ojeda goes the route, allows just five hits. Santana handles Peña's shot for a game-concluding double play. The Mets win 7-0 and threaten to end this thing by the All-Star break. Well, the month of truth begins at Yankee Stadium tonight. Finally, they clash with their key American League East rivals, starting with Baltimore tonight, and Boston will be in next week. Boston with the most wins in baseball. And last night, with back-to-back ninth-inning homers, this one by Dwight Evans off Mark Clear that followed a blow by Gedman, drew the Sox to within 7-5. They look dangerous once more. Clear walked two more Red Sox, two out. Boggs up to get the runners in place for the league's leading hitter. Double steal, but Steve Lyons cut down at third by Cerrone. The Red Sox, after winning the 15 out of 16, lose, and their lead over the Yanks reduced to 4 games. Well, the women's final at the French Open features the two best players in the game, Navratilova and Everett Lloyd, while the men's final has number one Yvonne Lendl against virtual unknown Michael Pernfors. Pernfors, a Swede, unseeded, never before having competed at the French, and today upset eighth seed Henri Leconte by sweeping the second, third, and fourth sets. Pernfors is himself amazed at his success, saying, "It feels like I can't miss." But it is very hard to picture him beating Yvonne Lendl, a man with a world of experience on him, and who, in sweatpants, on this 48-degree and rainy day in Paris, destroyed Johan Krieg 6-2, 6-1, 6-love. Day two of the Westchester Open is over, and there is a three-way tie for the lead. One of those three is not, however, Jay Haas, who was the co-first-round leader with Tom Siekman. He fell to a 2-over-73. This is Haas putt on 18 after a very unspectacular round. His putt for birdie was slightly off the mark there. As he approaches for the tap-in and makes it, he finds little life out of the crowd, which has some new potential heroes to follow in the weekend rounds. And they are yesterday's co-leader Siekman, Brett Upper with a 66 today, and Willie Wood, who blazed to a 63. Ray Floyd, with more experience than the tri-leaders combined, is one shot off. Tuil and Tway are at minus six. Well, day eight of the World Cup. A new champion will be crowned, by the way, on June 29th in Brazil. One of the top teams in the world won a second straight. The only goal, Algeria, guilty of some weak defense. Muller's crossing pass missed, and the other defender backs off. Carreca puts it in. Brazil, favored by the London bookies to win it all, and looking solid. Well, the track at Belmont is a muddy mess, and speculation is rising that Ferdinand, the heavy favorite who has never run in mud, will be scratched. And if that is the case, you got to know that Mogambo wins the race. I picked him already once, and he let me down. Tomorrow's got to be the day.
John's treasure.
John's treasure. John's Why treasure. Did you pick that? Big surprise.
Up next, the third jewel in the Triple Crown, the Belmont Stakes. Josh Howell will preview the big race.
For the hottest deals on the hottest wheels, plus all-time low 6.9 financing, see your Tri-State Chevy dealers now. Choose your Camaro, Cavalier Z24, or Corvette from the biggest selection ever and make your summer sizzle.
Yeah. Your Tri-State Chevy dealers got what you're looking for.
This is how many parents all across America find out about the Apple IIc. Parents buy their kids an Apple IIc because Apples are the leading computers used in schools. Then they discover how easy it is to set up and use, how it can help them with things like business and home finance, and how that can help them spend more time with their kids.
Hi, Dad.
I should be mature, Bobby. I mean, we just got engaged. But with you stationed overseas...
It's only 18 months.
Well, it's gonna be the longest year and a half of my life.
Saying goodbye is never easy, but with AT&T International Long Distance, it's easy to say hello. A 10-minute call to Japan can average just 95 cents a minute.
Voice.
Only AT&T can keep you this close anywhere in the world.
It's good to hear.
At Midas, we've always been proud of the job we do. A lot of our new customers are referred to us by our old ones.
Howdy, boys.
Welcome back, Mr. Creedy.
You see, good service, good prices. The word gets around.
Like our fantastic anniversary sale. We're giving you 25% off every Midas muffler. A sale like this doesn't come along every day.
Take it to Midas.
I love a sale.
Take it to someone you trust.
As we've told you, as you know, tomorrow's the running of the Belmont Stakes, the third jewel in the Triple Crown of racing. It is said that racing is the sport of kings. Given that, who else could we send to cover the following story other than Josh Howell?
This is something few people have seen, Belmont Racetrack at dawn. The magnificent thoroughbreds begin their workouts in the dark. It is surprisingly serene. And yet, this quiet beauty will give way to more than 50,000 screaming fans. It is the day before the Belmont Stakes. And this year, the purse could go over $500,000.
It's excitement. You know that there's only one day left. It's like the Kentucky Derby. It only happens once a year. And it's a big day.
Eddie Maple will ride a long shot in the race, but he will ride. I asked him how important that is to a jockey's pride.
Not to be in the big one, to be running on one of the other races that day, tomorrow. Must be, it's not quite the same, is it?
No, it's not. I mean, you can say to yourself, maybe next year, but that's a long ways off.
The question being asked now is, how will the rain affect the race? We asked these experts, the grand old men of racing. Walter Kelly's been training horses for 65 years. His horse, John's Treasure, is in the race.
A good, real good handicapper that bets his own money will not bet in the mud.
Will not bet on the muddy track?
No. Horses just don't run right in the mud.
So you don't know what to think about tomorrow?
I would say no.
Charlie Whittingham has trained the favorite, Ferdinand, which won the Kentucky Derby.
Do you think because of the rain and the sloppy conditions, that's going to throw the race wide open, or do you think Ferdinand still would be the standout in the field?
Well, he'll have to be the favorite in the race no matter what, and whether he'll run on an off track, I don't know.
Woody Stevens has won the last four Belmont Stakes in a row. His horse is Danzig Connection.
You don't know if your horse can run in this mud or not?
I don't know if he'll like it or not. They can all run to a point, but how good? That's the question.
Which horse will be immortalized as the 1986 winner of the Belmont Stakes? The experts say because of the rain, because of the caliber of the horses themselves, they just don't know. And yet, in less than 24 hours, we will all know. Josh Howell, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
You still say John's Treasure, eh?
John's Treasure. I was, in fact, going to go out there and see it, but with a muddy track, I may just watch it on ABC.
John, you're no treasure, but you are a pleasure to work with,
and thanks for being with me these past
couple days.
Thank you. And for all of us here at Eyewitness News, I'm John Johnson. Good night.
I'm Bill Beutel. For John and Eli and Bill and everybody else, thank you. Good luck and be well.
Ask your doctor about Nasonex with moisturizing glycerin, taken once a day for nasal allergies due to pollens, molds, dust, and yes, even pets. Side effects were generally mild, included headache, viral infection, sore throat, nosebleeds, and coughing. Nasonex. Fewer sneezes. Fewer worries.
A mother's neck is never ordinary. To place an extraordinary gift around it, come to K Jewelers. This Mother's Day, give Mom a K diamond necklace with diamonds hand-selected for exceptional beauty.
Every kiss begins with K.
K Jewelers.
A woman's body is about 70% water, yet it's natural to occasionally experience personal dryness. KY Liquid is water-based, non-sticky. It's from the number one doctor-recommended brand, KY Liquid.
Plastic is anything we ask it to be. At our defense in times of risk. Close at hand to help safeguard our lives and forever evolving before our eyes. It's in the airbag that protects us and a cell phone to connect us. An answer when we need it most. Plastic carries our hopes, letting us all look forward to a safer, more brilliant tomorrow. Plastics make it possible.
Last night on Dave, the castaways presented the top 10 Survivor pickup lines.
Forget the tribe. My pants have spoken.
Tonight, it's Joan Cusack in the CBS mailbag.
This is Sam. She's 27. She's an office manager. She's having a hard time managing her love life, though. 6 months ago, she ended a 5-year relationship. Right now, she's just looking to relax and have some fun. No strings attached. She didn't realize how hard it would be to get back into the game and find someone normal to hang with. Then a friend at work told her about telepersonals. She figured she had nothing to lose, so she called. Today, she's talking to Jeff. He's 33, in the same boat as her, and extremely funny. He knows how to let loose and have a good time, with no expectations. He also happens to have a best friend who's a fireman. Things could get interesting. Suddenly, the single life's not so bad, thanks to telepersonals.
Phone telepersonals now. It's a free call.